Hello and welcome to the Narc Alert, the channel where we look at YouTubers and others to see if they demonstrate any traits that fall within the spectrum of narcissistic personality disorder or NPD. These videos are for fun and entertainment purposes only, strictly my opinion, and remember, please don't send any snark to our possible narcs. So key points to remember? Messy fun and not a diagnosis. Hello, my lovely lurts, and welcome back to the Narc Alert. Happy Tuesday. Another week. We're almost in the middle of it. Let's hang in there. We can get through it. In the meantime, let's have a quick look at Amber's latest upload that she's calling Homeless Shelter, Confession, and My Meal Plan. Has she got anything new to share us? What is this deep, dark confession? Let's dive right in and find out.
Hey guys, welcome to a new video. Okay, so right now I am just cooking my first meal of the day. We're having eggs and this veggie patty that I've never tried before, but I thought it would be really good in my eggs.
Oh.
Black bean and quinoa.
Oh.
Veggie burger. This is what she looks like. I cook my eggs until the chicken is literally dead.
Let me tell you something. You're here. You can't cook. That's what's just been confirmed to me.
Isn't that weird that eggs are chicken?
Cookie girl.
I'm also having a mandarin. I am super excited. I see like some corn, which is from the veggie patty. I don't know. The only seasoning that I added was pepper, some tapatio, and garlic powder. I think we're gonna watch some Mama June. Okay, so we have some oil gates. I'm just trying to make a joke out of it. A lot of people were wondering why I do not count the oil when I use it. When I'm talking about calories, it is because I do not use anywhere near what a serving is. A serving is a tablespoon, and I just drizzle. I actually used to use water instead of oil to cut back on calories, but in my opinion, I feel like that's an unhealthy mindset. I'm already counting calories for literally every single thing that is going inside of my body. I think it's silly to count calories on a tiny bit of oil. So this is nowhere near a serving. The calories of oil that I actually use is probably about 30 calories, but if we want to be generous, we can say half a serving for 60 calories, which is fine with me. What I am doing seems to be working.
What's going on with you? What are you talking about?
So I'm gonna stick to what I'm doing, but I do want to show you guys what a serving of oil looks like versus how much I actually use. I think oil gate should be over after this. Anyways, I love you guys. I am gonna go through my purses.
No one cares!
Show you guys which ones I decide to keep and which ones I'm gonna give to Goodwill. I'm never gonna use this. I'm gonna be honest, ever since I've been stopping the estrogen and I'm like truly going through menopause.
Doctors taper their patients off HRT or estrogen depending on what type of HRT you are taking and how high the dose. It can take from 3 to 6 months to completely taper off. It can be as long as a year, particularly if your menopause symptoms reappear during the process. This can take weeks or months. It is unlikely you will experience hot flashes one day after stopping a 1 milligram, the lowest dose of estrogen.
So much hotter. More quickly.
Hot flashes are quick bursts of hot skin and often drenching sweat that last anywhere from 30 seconds to about 5 minutes. Your face and neck may turn red, your heart rate may increase, and you will most likely break out in a sweat. These sudden bursts, especially at night, can cause fatigue, irritability, and even forgetfulness. For 10-15% of women, hot flashes are so severe that they disrupt normal functions. It is much more than feeling warm.
It's not my cup of tea. I hate being hot. It's just not cute. It's not fun. I also hate being cold. Anyways, so I figured because like I really want to take you guys on this journey.
Gonna take a sentimental journey.
Like this is part of my life. I kind of want to share with you how I eat throughout the day. I gave myself some rules. I allow myself to have a serving of fruit and a premier protein shake. Then I allow myself 3 meals for the day. I don't snack.
Flashback.
I do not snack though anymore, but I do not snack. But for a meal, I want to try a ginger chew.
And a flashback.
I make all my meals at home. I don't order takeout. Like obviously I'm gonna order takeout. Like it's gonna happen eventually. It's so weird, like last night, like I kept saying in my head, McDonald's chicken nuggets, 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 McDonald's chicken nuggets.
Introducing Chicken McNuggets. McDonald's McNuggets.
I felt nothing. Really weird because that is like one of my binge foods, especially like at midnight or like 1 a.m. Really think Ozempic is taking away my cravings.
Oh.
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 Stopping takeout and stuff like that has definitely helped. Because takeout is freaking addictive.
Ordering takeout while habit forming is not truly considered an addiction. The food she is eating may be. The act of ordering food is not a diagnosis.
So it's like sweets and stuff, and I don't allow myself to have that.
I want to try a ginger chew.
Oh, also another rule that with every single meal I have to have either a fruit or a vegetable. So I've honestly been loving that. Every time I eat it, I'm like, ooh, I'm nutrient my body.
Amber tells us often how well schooled she is regarding nutrition, yet she eats so poorly, she thinks that adding a single veg is nutrying her body. It's a good start, Amber, but you need a lot more nutrient-dense food than a single veg.
I'm also naturally doing intermittent fasting. I don't think about food. I don't anymore. But I have a grocery haul for you guys, so let's do it. Okay, so I think it is time for a torrid. Someone just walked by. I usually change my clothes actually in here, and I always have the windows open. I wonder how many times people have seen me in the nude. Oh my God, I've been looking forward to this. And let's go. Okay, this is one of my most favorite dresses that I've bought in a while. So this is how she looks up close. I literally feel like I designed this. I used to make posters that look identical to this, but I wanna donate to the homeless shelter in the city that I live. So I think we're gonna go and just buy a bunch of things that I know the homeless shelter needs. Like, this is a reminder that you can help people in need, you know, just for a few dollars. I know I went probably overboard to a lot of people, but I don't think so at all.
Saint Lynn is here to remind us we can help. She did. She of course mentions she went overboard. She truly gives and gives.
So help when you can, even if it's just a little bit. I will say the first week on Ozempic, I did lose about 2 to 3 pounds, but I will say, today, I had a moment where I was like, I want to eat out, I want to order food, I want to have a cheat meal. Ugh, I haven't felt this way in a week. I'm fighting with that person. That's the old AMBERLYNN. This is the new AMBERLYNN, and I'm telling the old AMBERLYNN to shut the fuck up, and that's not happening. We're not ordering food. We're not having a cheat meal.
She is still white-knuckling through this as opposed to changing her relationship with food. The last time she gave this speech, she binged afterwards.
I did make myself a meal. We have a serving of just like chicken rice with some cheese on top. Huh. I always drop lettuce in my broth. Anyone else?
Well, no, Amber, I can't say that every time I eat a salad, I end up with lettuce in my broth. Not sure how you're managing that. Maybe try a napkin. Thank you again for joining me for our little re-edit of AMBERLYNN REID's Thaw. If you liked it, please click like and don't forget to subscribe. I would love it if you could grab a channel membership. It's only $1.99 and it's a lot of fun. Don't forget to join the Discord. You know, it's crazy in there. Until we meet again, you know the routine. Don't forget to be kind and hasta luego.